Hey everyone, welcome again to another stream, and we've got something a little bit different today. I thought I'd change it up a little bit and take a little bit of a break from Warframe, at least on stream, because I'm going to be honest with you, I've already played Warframe today. We went to the Tenocom Relay and Barrow and got some Prime mods and been looking at some builds and all that kind of thing. So Warframe, totally still in the picture, it's all still there. I just thought we'd have a little bit of a break and a little bit of a change and play some retro games, because I was looking through my retro games, as you do, you know, the other day, and you know, I thought, man, I really got a bit of a hankering to play Alien Breed Special Edition 1992, which is a very specific thing, I know, but Alien Breed was just always such a fantastic Amiga game. Still going today, actually. Well, maybe not today, but like Team 17, the developers of it, still exist today, and they still put out Alien Breed games from time to time. It still exists. I have them on PC. I've only played at least one of them up until now, and just whilst I'm talking here, I am stalling for time so I can do a tweet and then move on from there. Alien Breed is a thing which exists today and is still going in one way or another, and I have to admit, the last time I played it, I was not a huge fan of the newer sort of PC version, you know. But with that said, I haven't replayed it recently. I may have been in a bit of a bit of a thing at the time, not really in the mood for it, you know. Can I play some Alien Breed? Okay, and we'll get that off. Right then, let's see here. Got the stats, got the stream, got OBS. Okay, all good to go. Alright, so the thing is with emulators is you've always got just a couple of things to sort out and worry about. I did test this the other day, and everything seemed to be okay, so we should be good to go. There we go. No, of course it is kind of a cracked thing, because of course they're all cracked. Yeah, just move on from there. There we go. So it's going to load up. I'm actually going to let it go through the whole sort of loading sequence, because there is this, like the whole first disc of this game is an advertisement for another game, which which like there's a bit of a trailer for, but I really like the trailer. I really like the music in the trailer, I should say. So I'm going to let that play. I make sure I've got all this stuff set up for like keyboard and mouse and all that sort of thing. So as I remember, Alien Breed 2 was definitely a thing at the time. This is like Alien Breed 1.5 sort of thing. I never played the first Alien Breed, and I never played Alien Breed 2. So I only ever played this one and then the 3D ones, which like came out later. Alright, that should be fire. So this should be loading up in a minute. Anyway, it's such a weird little advertisement, this, like to put it in the first half of your game. And of course, this being Special Edition 1992, I think what it meant is that was basically a budget version, if I remember that correctly. There we go. So it was literally like a budget version, and then it's also got like this, essentially an advert for Super Frock, which at the time, when I saw it, I thought it was like super cool. Like I really wanted to give this game a go at the time, but I played this not recently, but in the last 10 years I've played this, and it's not great. I would have so liked to have played it like back then when I first saw it, because then I probably would have liked it a lot more, but playing this right recently, I was like, oh, this kind of feels like a bit of a bad Amiga platformer to me. I say bad, mediocre Amiga platformer. Hey, Jamie, how's it going, man? Good to see you. Thanks for popping by. I was going to check out some retro games on the Amiga, which used to be my old computer, which I used to play on as a youngster before PC and all that. It was kind of a thing. So we're just loading into it at the moment. Hey, doing alright? Yeah, I'm doing okay, mate. Thanks very much. I'm glad you're doing okay. I caught you streaming earlier on. I was just sort of looking in chat most of it. I was doing some Warframe stuff at the time, so I was kind of lurking. But yeah. God, this whole thing. Yeah, I remember this. I thought all the different worlds looked really interesting. Characters quite cute and all that as well, which, you know, good thing. Really loved the music at the time as well. That is possibly a bit loud, if I'm just looking at the thing here. Because the Amiga is like, it's always louder than the, louder than a lot of the other programs and stuff right now. There we go, it should be a little bit better. But yeah, it's a two disc game, and the whole first disc is basically this advert for, for Super Frog. Which I think came out a couple of years afterwards, or maybe a year afterwards. Video game industry was really different back then. Games came out a lot quicker, less work and all that kind of thing. Anyway, so we'll actually get into Alien Brood in a minute. It's going to ask for the second disc. Third disc two. There we go. I always really like the audio, because like actually having speech, like understandable human speech in a game was kind of rare at the time. I was like, I had the computer basically asking you for disc two. There we go. There we go. Cool. So I got some cheats for this, because this is close to, I don't say unplayable. It's very difficult to complete this, as games were back then, on a single set of lives and all that sort of thing. And I only ever played it with the cheats, to be fair. So we're going to play with the cheats again. So it's the standard sort of setting. You go to the space station, and you're a space marine, and the space station's been taken over by aliens, and you've lost. That's illegal. The space station's lost like contact with you know, higher ups and all that kind of thing. You gotta go there and find out what's gone wrong. So it's just the same old, you know. Heard this the song a million times and all that. And there we go. So we got that little like Doom Marine guy here with his green armor on, which at the time, well, I don't even know if Doom was a thing at the time. It probably wasn't. 1992, I think Doom was 1993. So yeah, kind of weird that like we've got a kind of green armor sort of thing going on here. Or maybe it's just a green jumper. Yeah, it's cold in space. You might just be wearing a jumper. But yeah, you got your ship here and all the engines in the back, and it's sort of all rare in a way there. I just kind of thought this is really cool when I was a kid. I suppose, who am I kidding? I think it's pretty cool now, to be fair. You can't go around the back and like immediately kill yourself or anything, so you know, there is that. So we go pick up some keys to get these doors open here, and then that's generally the sort of the cycle here. You got to pick up credits, you got ammo, and you got keys, and you got like life and energy and all the rest. And then there's the aliens around here somewhere, but you know you're not going to see them immediately. So these things on the wall are like a computer terminal, which is where you can do all the cheats and check out all the different weapons to buy and stuff like that. It took me forever to find this out when I was a kid, because I had no idea you could even do this, because like games were just sort of starting to get complex in a way, rather than just being like arcade sort of games at the time. And Yeah, like figuring out that you could walk up to these things and press space, you know, was just mind blowing to me. It's like, oh my god, there's a whole other thing inside this thing. So bear with me one second here. I gotta get the cheats because I can't remember off the top of my head. Alien Breed Special Edition 992. There we go. It's on me favorites. So we've got cheats like, strangely enough, there's no like unlimited money cheat. It's like a cheat which will skip you ahead like a bunch of levels and give you some money, but I don't want to do that. I just want to go through each level as best I can. But we're just going to have unlimited energy and unlimited keys. And what else we got? We got, see, there's a lot of like trolley sort of cheats here as well. I don't want to say cheats really, but like they'll turn the screen purple and make you invisible and all that kind of thing, but not in like in a helpful way. They just make your character invisible. All the aliens can still see you. You just can't see you. So yeah. Oh, and then there's a debug mode, which is pretty cool. Which I didn't know when I was a kid, but apparently there's a debug mode here. Let's put on the unlimited energy, which is, oh no, okay, that didn't work. I need to do, there's like a noise when it works, so I think, oh, I need to put spaces in. There we go. And then keys is key to the city. Excellent, there we go. All right, job done. Energy, keys, that should do it. So we don't have, where's the fire? There it is. We don't have unlimited ammo and we don't have unlimited lives or, nope, that's it actually. Just unlimited keys, unlimited health. But it does something weird with the health. Like it doesn't, it's not like unlimited. It lets you take damage, but then it like refills it up afterwards after like a little bit of time, because you can get enough damage where you still die and you lose a life. It's weird. It's got weird cheats. I'd say like glitchy cheats sometimes, but I think it's just the way it does them. You know, it doesn't just set your health to like 10,000 and then leave it to it. It's still like works in like a weird way. I never actually saw like the back end of all the cheats or anything like that. So, but we can basically just walk through the aliens now, more or less. But like this one, you've got to like manage your key. Well, I suppose it's like a survival horror game. You're going to manage your resources, you know. It's like a proto survival horror game or survival action game, maybe, you know. But I just love it. I always liked this as a kid. Oddly scary. I always thought it was like oddly scary before, you know. Oh, you think you just lost the critical wire? What did you lose? What's happened, Jamie? So I'm just gonna be like wandering through this pretty quickly, because I pretty much remember more or less where to go from all the way back then. I'm gonna try and take my time at the same time. Some of the later levels I definitely don't remember, so we'll see what happens. Micro USB? What's a micro USB for? So, I don't have enough money at the moment to get a decent gun, but we're gonna save up our credits and see if we can get a decent gun by the boss. So we basically just got to go all the way around the levels and pick up all the credits. But hopefully you can sort of get how, if we didn't have unlimited credits and, sorry, unlimited energy and keys and all that, this would be a little bit different, because you'd have to sort of decide what doors you're going to open, what doors you're not going to open, is it worth it, you know. Like right here, you're using up three keys, but you're getting back, so that's always good, and then you got to use another two, but then you get them back, so that's not so bad. And these look like keys, but they're not, they're credits. So it's like playing tricks on you already, you know. And when you're playing with a bit of a dodgy TV that doesn't display color properly, like I was when I was a kid, you don't really know that those aren't keys and they're actually credits, because you can't tell the difference between the color, because it's just yellow. But luckily, here we are as an adult. See, the aliens, they bloody follow you everywhere. They do as well. They come down here. Like, it's not very often that they do it, but they do do it. They get everywhere. They're like sand. You found it. You got your piano. Oh, no, no way. I didn't know you had a piano. A micro USB piano. I didn't know you were a musical, Jamie. Actually, that's really cool. Anyway, I always did the ambient sort of noise and stuff. Like, it's never been very doesn't have like a lot of music or anything like that. It's just got like that nice little sort of spacey, space station-y sort of hum and like computery noises in the background. And yeah, definitely got like that alien sort of vibe. Alien, all that kind of stuff. We gotta shoot the aliens occasionally. Otherwise otherwise the game's gonna think we're not really playing, you know. There we go. And the aliens all infinitely respawn, which also makes it like super difficult to make any kind of progress with them, you know. So you just feel like you're wasting your ammo whenever you shoot them. And it's like, but you know, that's the game, I suppose. Hence the cheats. Yeah, hope the game audio is okay, by the way. You have to let us know if it's too quiet or too loud or anything like that. Can sort of judge off going off the levels, the audio levels, like in OBS and stuff, and it's not a bad way to go, but sometimes, you know, never quite get it. You know, it's the sort of the animations sort of delay a little bit, so you just sort of walk through the doors and then they open afterwards, because it's like too busy showing you the credits and stuff, which I always thought was really weird as a kid. You can actually shoot through the doors as well. It takes like loads of ammo, but if you really need to, you can just sort of blast through them. But that's, again, that's just all your trade-off is. You're either use up all your ammo or use a key. But they give you a nice little sort of feedback that you're shooting a door, you know. It's got that sort of different sound effect there, which I really like. But the best thing about having unlimited keys is we can just go everywhere and pick up all the keys or whatever there is, you know. Oh, so satisfying. There we go. Alright, that's where we gotta go, but we're gonna just pick up this ammo here. Not that we need it, but, you know, just in case. I'm just gonna get 100% collection. Not that the game even tracks that, but it just makes me feel good. As you go through each level, it's sort of, you get that text crawl at the start, and it kind of progresses the story and like what's going on with the aliens and stuff as you go and all that. And it's all very, very sort of taken from Aliens and like the Xenomorph, all that kind of thing. Like, tell me that these don't look like the aliens from Alien with the heads. Although they are obviously legally completely distinct, because they're not exactly the same as the Xenomorph from Aliens. Legally distinct, but you can tell where they come from. Anyway, here we go. So we're on the power system. We're gonna blow it up. Like, it's like, we think that you should probably just blow up the top two decks. I think that would be a good idea. take out the fourth power dome. Let's get out of there before the blast hits. Once unstable, you have 60 seconds to flee to the next level via the deck lift. Radar indicates movement directly below current position. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, the aliens, they're below you. Which leads to this level being a little bit different. In that, although I guess it's a bit more purple, the floor's a bit more purple than the last one. But they've got holes, and the aliens have this kind of gross sucking sound as they come up through the floor tiles. So we're going to have that for the next level or so. And if you stand over the things, they just kind of keep coming in. You know, kind of take your energy down. So we're not going to do that. Alright, I thought this was a power dome initially. That's not a power dome. It doesn't look power domey enough. Although it's definitely a dome of some sort. It's definitely not a power dome. It's probably more of a sandwich dome. That's a power dome. So we're actually just going to leave that there and not shoot this one. Because we've got four. But the way that the level's laid out is that we've got some one-way doors, and if you take it like the way like this, then you end up getting the last one, which happens to be the furthest away from the deck lift, which means, you know, getting back's kind of a little bit tense. But if we do it that way, then it's nice and quick, and we can just immediately go back to the deck lift. So weapons wise, we've only got, you know, 40,000 credits, which is not enough for anything. We can buy a double barrel shotgun, which is not really a shotgun, it's more like a laser shotgun, I guess, but, you know. The Arc Flame Rapid Fire, which is pretty good. We could just about afford that, which is a plasma gun. It's a pump action plasma gun. And there's the Flamethrower, which is 48. And then what we actually want is this triple barrel thing, which I don't remember ever using. There's this thing, which is the Astro Laser. It's the High Impact Astro Laser laser. I suppose it's actually called the Astro Laser, and then it is a laser, so it's a laser laser. But that's like 75,000. So we're going to need to save up some credits for that. But that's really good, because the projectiles sort of bounce off the walls, and it's really good. And just why we're here, because I didn't show the rest of this before. We can buy like these other things. We can get like a remote location scanner, which I believe is like basically a map, but you can take it with you, because otherwise you can only use the map, which is part of these computer systems. Very useful for some of the late levels, I think, where the computer system doesn't work. I think that's correct, but I can get all the maps online, so shrug. Ammo charge, so more ammo, and buy a high energy injection, which is the life thing, and key packs, and then, you know, just like real life, you can buy additional lives from the computer as well for 30,000 credits, which I believe is what a lot of people are doing these days. So I need to save up, and, you know, I'll choose between buying a house or buying an additional life. I don't know what I'm going to do, but hey, one day. You got your radar. Sorry, terrible jokes. Real estate jokes, wonderful. Right, so we got the map system. So we're up here at the top. The deck lift is in the center, and then the other two panel domes are left, right, and below. So, but this is a one way system as well, which kind of sucks, but we'll find it out as we go. And what else we got? Mission objectives, that just tells us what it told us at the start. It gives us a password for starting there again as well. Because again, no saves on games back then, so we've got the enter code KKDFA to restart here. So you just put that password into like these computer systems here, and then you can just skip to the level. In text entertainment, I remember this not working, so I think it's yeah, it just shows you an error message and says it's not there, it's not installed. Super Space Frog installed early in the next millennia. Yeah, that's the thing. Game statistics, you know, Aliens Killed 89 already. Score as if, you know, points when they used to matter, I guess. You know, I suppose that's always XP now. A lot of games these days, but yeah, points, shots fired, credits, doors, ammo packs, current weapon, energy state, good. It's good. And we don't own all the weapons, we only have the machine gun, but hey, there we go. And info base, what is the info base? I don't remember this at all. Contained data files do not conflict with current HDs or HQ security regulations. All records considered low priority. Is this? Oh, I see, yeah, it's like telling you about the system and the space station and all the rest of the stuff. Okay. Anyway, and that's everything in there, so a couple of useful things, but you know. Alright, we're going this way. Right, these like long sort of tunnel things here, I always, because I was nuts about Aliens, like the film Aliens, when I was playing this at the same time, like, the two kind of happened at the same time for me. You know, I watched Aliens and played this as well, and I think these two probably coincided with each other. I know Alien Breed, the first one, was definitely, I guess we can't get through here, might be the other way. It was definitely, you know, based on a lot of the Alien stuff. But those sort of long tunnels always remind me of that bit in Aliens where, like, Bishop's gonna go through the tunnel to get to, it's like the satellite uplink or something like that. Been on a bit of an Aliens kick recently, so this is all quite fresh in my mind. Alright, we're just gonna walk through all these guys. Oh, Jamie, you've only seen AVP2. Oh, man. Don't take this the wrong way, but that's the worst one. Oh, AVP2. I do like watching it occasionally for the jokes, to be honest. It's not a great film. Oh, it makes me so sad as well, because, you know, Aliens and Predator as well, for that matter. Like, both Aliens and Predator, so part of my childhood in a really weird way that they probably shouldn't be, because I wasn't old enough to watch them, but you know. Right, we can't go this way, that's coming up that way, I guess we're gonna go this way. But yeah, like Terminator, Aliens, Predator, Robocop, I guess, as well, like all that kind of stuff. Huge part of my childhood. AVP1's okay. It's not the best film ever, but it's certainly not bad. It's enjoyable to watch. And it's PG-13 as well, so it's a good introductory sort of film for parents that want to show their kids Aliens and they're not old enough for, you know, Alien. Yeah. Oh, Jamie, don't worry about it. I'm just teasing, man. I have to admit, like, I'm all for, like, recommending films to people and all that kind of thing, but I get the whole thing of, I get it myself a lot, where people are like, oh man, you haven't seen X, you've really got to watch X, and it's just like, oh man, I'm just not interested in watching X. You know, like, the more you go on about it, the less I kind of want to watch it now. You're kind of turning me off from it because you're making such a big deal out of it. So yeah, believe me, dude, I totally get it. So I try not to be that annoying kind of person who does that to other people. Like, I love me some aliens and Predator and all the rest of the stuff, but at the same time, you know, it's like I keep on going the wrong way. It's not a big deal. People will go through their lives and survive with no problem. Not without seeing Aliens or any other film for that matter. Like, it's not the end all and be all, you know. But that said, I really do like those films. They're great. Been watching a bunch of Netflix stuff. Watch what you've been watching. I actually cancelled my Netflix just this month, just because I actually wasn't really watching it all that much, you know. I kind of felt like I was wasting money on it. It's been a couple of months since I really spent any time watching it, and I've kind of got more than enough time, more than enough other stuff to watch without that. So I just figured I'd cancel and sort of save some money, really. I think we'll just kill all these aliens like that. There we go. Been watching Bottom, excellent stuff. Life on Mars, Ashes to Ashes. I thought I said Ashens to Ashens. I was like, oh, hey. That YouTuber made a TV show, huh? oh, man. Ashes to Ashes, sorry, yeah. Life on Mars, Ashes to Ashes. Cool stuff. I've heard good stuff about Life on Mars. I've never actually seen it myself. Bottom, I remember from, like, ages ago now, but Bottom was always good. Rick Mail was always a real funny dude. I forget the other guy in it now as well, but he was good as well. Yeah, the young ones and all that as well. Yeah. Totally, man. Oh, dude. It was like Red Dwarf as well. Sort of, Red Dwarf was always a favourite as well. Aid Emerson, that's it. Yeah, that's the guy's name. Yeah, I'm terrible for names. I really, really am. Right, I think we'll be ready to shoot this other one and escape through here. I think I've got that right. Mind really does wonder when you're chatting away on the stream. You forget that when you don't stream for a bit. You forget how much your attention really does split between the two. Alright, Security Zone, Duke 3, unfortunately, last trying to power. Yeah, unfortunately, surprising absolutely no one, something went wrong again. Meltdown spread into this level, if not start, the whole station could blow. Immediate closure of all fire doors, that's it, this is the fire door one, isn't it? Fire doors are a little bit glitchy sometimes, so we have to be careful with them. Activated, return to the deck lift and await instructions. Radar malfunctioning, erratic readings. Advise caution. I don't remember what that means. So this could be fun. Oh, we're back to the other aliens now without like the little mouth things on the front. Also no holes. So no sort of sucking noises. I don't know what else to call them. Shall we see if we can walk through that? I don't remember if we can walk through that. It doesn't look like we can walk through it, but hey, there we go. I guess we can. I just like how smooth this feels. It's I suppose it's like a, you know, old CRT sort of style game. So it's like 50 hertz, 60 hertz, something around that. So it sort of, it's going to feel really good. Oh, it actually says on the screen down below it's actually 50 hertz, so yeah, it's 50 FPS. Just feels really good. It's a very smooth game. I forgot how for all games were like this. Like, you actually got some resistance and stuff on certain floor tiles and all that as well as you're walking around. I don't know if it really shows up sort of watching it, but there's occasionally, like, you walk over, like, a certain tile or grate or something, and it sort of slows you down or sort of causes some sort of almost a feeling of resistance when you're walking over it. It's cool. So that's a fire door thing. I know there's four of them, and I think this operates in the same way as the power thing, where you shoot the last one and that's when the alarm goes off. So we're going to kind of wait until we find all the fire doors first, I think, as soon as we've got time on our side, because we're cheating. Get those credits. So you gotta be careful here, like with the way you're shooting, because you will hit stuff that's off the screen. So if you shoot like in the right way, you can hit those buttons and close the fire door, which ain't necessarily a good thing. You don't necessarily want that. We're getting like a lot of like key drought. And then there's like all these keys just in this one room, so like if I were playing this without cheats, you could sort of understand, sort of see how it might get sort of tricky. You get backed into a room with no keys or something, you know? Does just seem so laughable though that he's all just walking up to these aliens just to get rid of them. And then like a, who the hell made this room? And just the architect of the space station is like, I'm just gonna put this this swirl in the middle of the space station. Right, let's go down there first, see what we got. See if we got enough money for, there we go, for the thing. For the, I say for the thing, for the weapon. Oh, 1 second, guys. Bear with me. What we got? We've got, oh wow, now we've got tons of money. 3,420,500. Okay, good stuff. Good stuff. Oh, I've got an email from TV licensing. Fantastic, thanks, man. Cheers. Oh, that was this month, though. Okay, then. Awesome. So British. Okay. Right. Yeah, we'll buy that. We'll have that. See, we've still got 58,000 left now. Now, unfortunately, I think we can only carry one weapon at a time. We haven't really got weapon switching at the time, so I think... At least I think so. It says we've got machine gun, it says we've got laser. So... Also says current weapon, machine gun there, but I believe that's because we haven't gone out and come back in yet. We'll see how we go if we go back in. We'll skip that. Game statistics. Yeah, now we're on laser. Okay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you couldn't switch weapons. Because if I went here, I can't buy the machine gun or switch to the machine gun from here. I could just buy it again, I guess. Okay, well, never mind. So, let's see what this new gun's like. That's the one, and it bounces around. Kills the alien in one shot. I think it'll kill a bunch of them if you put them, you know, in the line as well, so. There we go. Life goal reached. It's getting 1,000 credits there. A lot of money just being left around. In the space station as well. Maybe it used to be Space Wall Street. Oh, go in a twill room. Don't know what else to call it. Who would make that, seriously? See, these things as well, you gotta be careful with these bouncing around, because again, if it bounces around there into the fire door area and then hits one of those buttons, you're potentially locked out of where you need to get to. Get those, what are these, 100 credits? That little sort of hump in the floor there. Got a little speed bump. Completely missed the alien. Yeah, there we go. Now we got it. Alright, we still haven't closed any of these doors yet. Which is good, because I don't want to get... I remember there being something to do with the doors and very easily managing to trap yourself on like one side of or the other of them. So I want to get like a decent layout sort of in my head before we do anything. Because we're not going to die here, damn it. So I end up shooting, waiting for it to bounce around to see if it's going to get the aliens, and if it doesn't, then go, oh, okay, well, I'll just walk up to it then. Okay, well, we've got everything there now. Okay, yeah. So we know we've got aliens up here. Aliens up here, of course, we've got aliens everywhere, of course we have. Fire doors, I meant, up here. Let's just get these as well. This is not a speedrun of any thought. Okay, no worries, Jamie. Thanks very much for stopping by and having a chat with us, dude. Appreciate it. Yeah, you take care as well, yeah? And take it easy. Got the laser there. Okay, yeah. So that's probably going to be the shortest one there. I've got that. Okay. I'm gonna get back to the computer, so I can see the map. Got another fire door, we're gonna close that in a minute. I just wanna look at the map first. Okay, so we've got a fire door there. We've got a fire door roughly about there. And then we've got one up in this corner here. I suppose you can't see the mouse cursor, because that's not on the emulator. Fair enough. Okay. There we go, okay. Alright, we're gonna find the fire door around here. And we're gonna close it. Because this is probably the most sort of complicated area, really. And it's the furthest away as well, so. There we go, that's closed. So we've got nothing but time until we hit the last door. So let's hope we don't get this one wrong. All right. Okay, that's two down. I've just got these two over here. There's that one, there's this one. Not gonna lie, thought we had one more. I thought we had a bit more time. I guess not though. So there's four doors. I think we've got to close three of them. Then obviously not four of them. Fair enough. Hey, well, we did it anyway. Right then, so Oval Zone. Deck full, threat from fire and blast has receded somewhat. Well, that's a good thing. Giving you a chance to gather your thoughts, information suggests that the next deck harbors a massive alien presence, and it is there that your next mission awaits. Proceed with all speed to the engineering deck. RTHAA to restart here. Is this the dark one? No, this isn't the dark one. Okay, that's good. There's one which is just pitch black. It's after the reactor blows up or something like that. Okay, well, let's keep going here. We got another fire door there. Got some more one-way laser doors. We've got slightly different looking aliens here. And we got these. We got those things. Not actually 100% sure what we're going to do with this one. We might just have to get to another lift or something, or elevator, but whatever you want to call it. I do like the fact we got light face huggers on this one as well. Oh, look at them all. Oh man, there's so many aliens. Feels like there's a ton more in this one than there was in the other ones. Can I guess that? Oh wow, okay, coming up from there. Is this death if we fall down there? I mean, I guess it is. I don't really want to jinx that. Those are like square things. I feel like they were something as well, but man, I can't remember. I'm just going to thank God for unlimited energy at the moment. Jeez. Yeah, this is a big old question mark from me. I don't remember this one too well. What are we gonna do? We're gonna go here. Laser, one-way laser thing there. One-way laser thing there. Alright, let's keep going. See if we can find a computer terminal. Maybe we can look at the map. Yeah, if I press M, nah, it doesn't load a map. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. I thought it might do, but I guess it doesn't. We'll go through here and see what's on this side. I'm trapped there. Oh, that might be where we gotta go. We've got these two things here, which means this is one way. Yeah, open the door for no reason. And it's a good thing that this is top down, isn't it? Because if it was first person, you'd be opening doors to, you know, find things and never actually find anything in there. Ah, okay. I'm starting to see maybe the puzzle to this one now. That's where we gotta go. All these laser doors are like one way against where we gotta go. A little bit of a glitch there, so we're just gonna ignore that. that's one way as well. Yeah, okay, I see what the thing is with this one. I suppose what the gimmick is. So we've been that way. Yeah. Let's go back all the way to where we were. We'll go one of the different ways. Whoops. And caught in the barrel. Oh no, actually, let's go through there. Okay, so we've got that. Oh man, shooting those things around. Actually gives me more anxiety. Okay, we got a choice. We can go that way, which I think we came there before, or we can go that way, which we've also come from there before, so I'm gonna ignore that. Go down here. Okay, we got another one here. I feel like we went that way as well. Like I'm pretty sure we've come through that corridor sort of section there before. So let's not go that way. Yeah, this is just a good old-fashioned maze level. Not very much resources in this one either. A couple of keys there, and that's it really. Not much else. Oh well, I think this is where we gotta be. And I'm just gonna have a quick look around here. I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. Cool. Engineering Zone 1, Deck 5. An evil smell fills the air as you arrive in the... an evil smell. Define an evil smell. Smells like evil. Okay, fills the air. As you arrive in the first of a series of engineering decks, which comprise the major section of the whole station, HQ are pleased to inform you that there's something big in there. Terminate whatever you find and make your way down to deck 6. I think this is the boss level. So I couldn't even fathom playing this game like as was intended. Like this must have been pretty difficult, to be fair. Maybe you could get through like a level on its own and then get the password for each level and get through that way, but I don't know, maybe it was really easy. But it seems like it would be difficult to me. I wonder what happens if you shoot these doors. I suppose they just close and you lose access to that area, which would probably suck. Oh well. I think I should stick with the gun I got, because it's obviously the best one, because it's the most expensive. Although, that being said, speaking of Warframe things, when I did go to Barrocketeer, the Tenecom relay today, I'd look at the mods and stuff, because I was looking at getting some Prime stuff. I had Prime mods for... I've been checking out builds and all that online, and trying to get, now still passes out, people are building builds for still path, and like, doing some really great work and all that. And I thought, well, I'll take a look at these, see if I can build something similar to one of these builds, because obviously they're going to have lots of mods and stuff that I don't. Let's see if I can get something close to that to make it, just so, you know, I can kind of kick ass in my current frames and see if I can figure out a bit more from the bit more in the way of like how the mods work and what's good, what stacks, and all that kind of stuff, just because like I get it but I don't fully understand. I'm not too sure like what's good, what's bad, how things sort of go together, you know. I'm not great at sort of build stuff, so I did kind of like I liked what they've been doing just myself so far, you know, but I kind of wanted to pick someone else's brain, someone who's a lot more sort of into it and knows how these things work, knows how the math works, you know, figure that out. So anyway, I was looking at mods for that. I picked up some good mods as well. Pretty, just like the basic sort of, you know, primed, what's it called, flow and all that kind of stuff, you know, and good mods for abilities and strength and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, I've still got to rank them up and all that, but you know, it's good place to start. I'm going to get some of the cosmetics and stuff as well, because Barricadier stuff is really, really cool. Kind of want to take advantage of this this Tenocon and this like dual Tenocon visit as well, for what it's worth. Looking forward to checking that out as well. So you do sort of slide off these a little bit. Anyway, let's go through it. So I was checking that out, I was looking at the most like expensive mods and all that kind of stuff, and it's like I forget what it's called now, but it's one of the prime things. It's for a sniper rifle, and it's like 1,000, 2,000 ducats or something, and 1,000,000 credits, and it's like, it's really expensive. And I was looking at it going, man, that's not for me, because I don't generally use a lot of sniper rifles, you know, granted, but I was just looking at it going, wow, I guess that must be like maybe one of the best or something. And then I was watching DK stream, and he was talking about it, and it's like, it's really not, it's not one of the best mods or anything. And I just thought, it's probably not really worth it then. But if you're coming in not knowing that, like I did, you might pick it up and just be thinking, great, I got this fantastic mod. But it's like, I'm glad I didn't buy it just blindly, just because it was like, oh, it's the most expensive thing there, so it must be the best. Because it's like, firstly, I don't, you know, as I say, I don't really use sniper rifles that much. No, I probably should, but you know, I just generally don't use them all that much, and that mod would have been zero use to me. But anyway, it just made me think. I'm glad I didn't just pick it up blindly. Anyway, and then here I am, basically doing the same thing with this gun. It does kill the aliens in one shot there, and it's probably really very good. I doubt, not throwing shade at this game or anything, because I love this game, but I doubt this game is as deep in the meta. I doubt this game's meta is as deep as Warframe's. Also, computer terminals everywhere. I definitely want you to consider what you're going into the fight with. That's interesting. Now, I remember, I'm sure that there is an area, and I think we might be coming up to it. I don't know. Oh, I should look at one of the maps on the computer terminals, which I've been walking past and not doing anything with. Yeah, that looks like quite a big open area, yeah? I have a feeling. And that could be our boss area. Let's just double check here. I'm pretty sure it is. Radar. Yeah, that's it. You look at all those rooms and it's like, I think that big one's maybe the thing where the big thing is. I'm going to need to get some water, but let's do this first. Well, at least it came back and got him, I suppose. Right, there's a lift here we've got to get immediately after this, so I just want to get it. I think it's... And obviously, we don't want to go through there just yet, because it'll be a waste of time. But, yeah, okay. It's down there. Oh, there we go. See, at least this doesn't look like the Alien Queen or anything. That would be bad, right? That would be copyright infringement. I don't like that wiggling thing there, that's kind of gross. Man, this must really suck if you don't have unlimited energy. Nope, there we go. We ain't got very long to get out either, so... They do kind of purposefully put you in the dark a little bit with this one, don't they? I seem to remember it being this way, but it might not be. Not Decklift, there we go. They did it. That's the one. Yeah, man, there's a little bit of memory from goddamn decades ago there, just working away, just a little bit. Jeez. Alright, engineering subsystem, Deck 6. The creature you have just slain is now reported to be just one of a number located in the station. You don't say. Yeah, that was not the queen like I was expecting. So I guess my memory is sort of remembering the queen later on rather than that one. Control assumed the queen and we're looking somewhere quiet and well guarded, somewhere deep in the heart of the station. Make your way to deck 7, engineering main deck. Alright. So again, I was expecting this to be the dark one. So I guess that must be coming up at some point. I gotta watch where I'm chewing, man. I gotta remember. I gotta trap myself. It's a very, very good atmospheric level though. Like it's fantastic. It's got so much like lighting, I wanna say, even though it's like obviously pixel art lighting. It's not dynamic lighting or anything like that. Or even pre-baked. I suppose it is pre-baked in a way, because it's pixel art. So it's just drawn that way. Anyway. Anywho, yes, it's a really good level. Oh, it's a good looking level, and it's very atmospheric. I remember that about it. For some reason, I remember it being a bit of a pain to like play though, and I'm thinking it's because you couldn't touch the walls. I think that's what it is, anyway. But well, we'll probably find out. What the hell is that? Oh, I remember that. That's a trick. That little smiley face there, like, I remember that as well. In this game. That's a trick. Like, if you grab that, you kind of get shafted a bit. I think it blows up the level, so you've got to, like, not get that. And kind of, like, ignore everything else around it as well. I remember that. It's such a douchey thing to do in a level as well. Especially in a game like this. There's a very good chance though, now that I think about it, that only appears if you use the cheats. I may have read that somewhere now. Can't remember if that's true or not. No, in this game it's not, it's just there anyway, just to screw with you. Because again, they liked doing that. Oh, maybe it's a form of copy protection, who knows. I don't know. Oh yeah. It's weird how memories come up from like decades ago, you know, and sort of remind you that about like that bit specifically, like, oh yeah, you can't get in through this door because that's in the way, and it's like as soon as you see it, you remember it. But you couldn't say that to me like on any old normal day and you know, expect me to remember. Got some bad holes in this floor, man. It's time to call the guy who does the floor. Another fire door there. I know I kind of want to close the fire doors, but I just don't think it's a good idea. I do think it like traps the aliens on either side though, so I think they probably helps in that way. Let's have a look at the map. Radar service. There we go. Oh yeah, no, this is heck load more complicated than I was thinking. Okay. So I'm gonna say because I actually still need to get my water. I forgot to get some water. Let me just put the BRB up. I'm going to go for a quick pee break and grab some water, and I'll be right back. What time is it as well? It is 22:01 a.m. Okie doke. Okie doke. Alright, bear with me, guys. I'm going to be right back. Okay, guys, I'm back. Got a fresh mug of water. And I think we're already ready to go. Okay. So where were we? What were we doing? Something about aliens? Okay, yeah. You know what, actually? Let's go back to the computer for 1 second. Mission objective. Where are we going? So, yes, aliens, all that sort of stuff. We're going to go to deck 7. So we're trying to get to the next level thing. And which means there we are. There's a lift here somewhere which we need. God knows where we started. I wish it put on here where you started from, but you know, there you go. I think that's where we've been now, and I want to go to some of these places on the edge and open up some of these doors, see what's in there. I think down in the bottom, like, there seems to be, I think I remember this now. So down in the bottom right hand corner, you got the three doors, the three black squares or rectangles. We got a rectangle there, and then one on the left of those doors. I think that is where the lift is. I seem to remember it being there. So what I might do is go that way, take a look at it. If that's where it is, then we'll go explore a little bit more and go from there, I think. Right, so we can't get through there because there's a wall there, and there's also a wall there. So I'll try going through this way. There we go. Now we're on the other side of that wall, and this is where we came from. This is where we started. At least I think so. I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure. 65% sure. So we got that. Man, did I just go like in a huge circle there? I think I just did, didn't I? There's something about those maps never quite looking like the lift. God, what am I saying? Sorry, the map not looking quite like these levels, like, really. Yeah, I do remember some of these levels being harder to navigate than the others. They do kind of all blur together in one way or another, you know? Here we go. I think we're going the right way now. Again, thank God for the unlimited keys. I thought I might have got stuck on a wall there, so it's a good thing we didn't. Because that's a bad time. Look at these... Like, you're never going to want to open those doors unless you've got limited keys, and then it's like, it's almost like you just want to, just to prove that you've been there. Like, leave your mark almost, you know? Ah, here we go. These are some of the doors I wanted to get through, just because there's all these doors in a row. And I kind of just want to see what happened. Oh yeah, no, we gotta be careful with that. I do remember this now. I'm not going any closer to that. I don't trust it. I remember that being a bad time. It might even be like when you touch it, like if cheats are on, then it goes, and if they're off, then you're fine. I don't know. I'm sure that has something to do with that. Actually unbelievable, but I'm actually getting kind of precious about my progress. I don't want to lose it, even though I could just look up the codes for the level, but It's like, no, this is the run. We're doing this. Alright, there's another fire door. See, it's enough of a challenge for this game. Just to figure out the levels, let alone worrying about your resources as well. It was always something I kind of liked as a kid and as an adult as well, to be fair, or at least a pseudo adult. So I suppose this was my first, or one of my first interactions with like environmental storytelling, because you're like, you've got all this stuff going on with the environment, all these effects, and you can tell stuff has happened at least before you got here, and you're almost trying to put together like an idea of what's happened before you got here. And I always liked that. I mean, I suppose it's good that there's not like some messages scrawled in blood on the floors and stuff like there is in Dead Space and all that kind of thing. Like, that would be so funny to see that. It's like, oh no, look, it goes back this far, you know, that trope. But at the same time, anyway, at the same time, I do like seeing all this. So I feel like we're coming close to the end. We're not going to go through there just yet, because I don't know why we want to. So we've got more resources there. I think we've got to go that way, haven't we? Now, is this just a big circle? It does seem like it. Okay. There's that. And there's that. Okay. Can I get in there from here? No? Okay. After a minute, I wonder what this would have been like in two player. I never played this in co-op. I suppose we were both on the same screen. I don't think I even ever tried. Oh, maybe I did. I just don't remember. Gotta be getting close to the end now. I swear to God. it feels so familiar. I feel like it must be around here this way. There's some place around here. I'm not sure. There was a sec. Okie dokie. There it is. Well, maybe that's why it felt familiar. Alright. Like, there's something to be said, like, a lot of modern, and probably previous, past criticisms of Amiga games, but a lot of modern criticisms of Amiga games is that they're so quiet, because, like, the Amiga had really good sound hardware, it had really good sound devices. Had like four channels of stereo audio, so two left, two right. But it meant that most games, because they were basically ports from like Mega Drive and all the other similar kind of things, similar sort of platforms to the Amiga, like that. God, there's another one there as well. Maybe that's what it was. So there's a trick to this. I remember this. So we can go here, and it won't go. We have to go all the way through here, hit that, which means we only have 1 second there, and yeah, you've got to be really, really quick with it, and I wasn't quick enough. There we go. I'm gonna use the old cheats to get to that. I am not letting that go. I remember that being a thing, but yeah. Ah, dear. It literally gives you like 2 seconds as well. It's impossible. Can I just type? No. The Amiga had a keyboard, but never let you type. You had to use the bloody keyboard. Joystick. Is it just three, or do we get more? Oh, okay. There we go. Right. We're going to start again. I'm going to run a password, I think. We'll get back up to that level. So, let's get into the game here. It's just gonna load. There we go. So I always thought this marine, I'm assuming it's a marine, space marine, I always thought like he had like a red helmet on, but now I'm thinking maybe it's like a Duke Nukem sort of style, like flat top haircut, and he's got like, you know, gingerish, sort of light gingerish, maybe the sort of red hair. I just can't. I don't know why I'm thinking about this now, but I just can't figure it out. So, is that a helmet or is that hair? Could be either. I can't really tell from the pixels. Alright. Let's find these passwords for these levels. We have to do the cheats again as well. I think we're going to have to do that just in case. Where are they? Oh, there they are. Here we go. So that's energy and then keys. Okay. And then levels. So, God, why does it do it this way? Why is there like level? Where's that level? Why does it start at 10? Oh, whatever. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It's probably just the way it's come over from. The from this from a CMS migration. That's probably the way it's come over from that. Shall we do PPEAB? Get 5 million credits. Jump to level 10. Let's hope level 10 is where we were. Can always see how we go if that's not the right one. PPPAB. I guess that's not the right one. Are you still streaming okay? Yeah, okay, that's good. Seems to be okay. Okay. guess that's not the right one. Maybe it's not the right one. Just seeing on Twitter, actually. I know, man. Hey, I was just a Twitter addict. It's like, oh, I'm just gonna look for these cheats. Let me just try Twitter. Helen's cosplay is like fucking amazing. Jesus. I mean, I never saw any of this stuff because like I wasn't following like Warframe and stuff back then. But Jesus, that's really good. Stuff. Anyway, right. See, I think we're on level 10, but I actually don't know now. We can't be on level 10. Like, if there's one, there's two, and there's three, four, five. We must have been on six. Six, maybe seven. I'm gonna try seven. So, CFD. FEF. EFJ. No, it doesn't seem to be doing it. That's well weird. How come this isn't working? I'll type this anytime to go to that level. Man, they're anytime codes. I thought they were index codes. Alright. In the newer Alien Breed games, the modern ones, like I was saying, they still have index as well, which I really like. At least they kept that in kept that canon. I really must try the newer Alien Breed games at some point just to see if they are just modern recreations of the old ones or how they sort of sit with me. These days. I remember not really liking them much back in the day, but you know, that doesn't mean nothing really. I checked out the Chex Quest sort of HD remake the other day, and I have to admit I was kind of let down. I was hoping it was still going to be like the traditional sort of 2D in a Doom engine kind of thing, but maybe it resed a little bit or just running in like a Windows sort of wrapper, so it didn't need to be in DOS or any of that kind of stuff. Maybe just up resed so, you know, the graphics look nicer or something like that. I wasn't expecting it to be what it looks like, which is like an essentially a complete HDification, HD like remake. Well, remake being the operative word, not just a an up-res, like a remaster. It is just a remake, and I admit, like, to me, it feels really bad. It feels like a really bad Unity game. I don't like it, and I'm kind of sad about it. It's like, man, kind of wanting that to be a better thing, but never mind. There we go. I mean, yeah, let's go for this CFD. Jeez. CFD FEFEFJ. Yeah, it's not doing it, man. Let's try with the thing on. EF. EFJ. That's with caps lock on. It doesn't seem to be making much difference. Here's a pause. That's fair enough there. Oh dear. 500 credits. Start to play a game. Go to share credits option. Number one. It's gonna be, yeah, I'm not doing that. I don't wanna play a two-player game. Type this anytime during the game to go to that level. I must be doing something wrong here. Let's have another look at some of these nice, okay. I just want to see some of these other cheats. It's quite funny, actually. Oh man, I don't even know what that says. Which is worrying, because it might say something like really super embarrassing. I don't know. So let's not pay too much attention to that. General Motors, that's one. these were always like really general motors. Oh, there you go. They must be big fans of General Motors. I was expecting this to be kind of insulting, because I know some of these are insulting, which is why I'm not picking them and going through these other ones. So that one where it says keep up the good work, that's Sega. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Okay. We got an Amiga format. I was always an Amiga format fan. Oh yeah, did they give Akari Warriors like something ridiculous? I think they didn't like Akira Warriors, or they gave it a lot. It wasn't a very good game. I can't remember now. That's super funny though. That's super funny. Okay. Anyway, where are we gonna go? Where are we gonna go? Let's go to. Oh, 1 second. Maybe it's a Twitch. Nope. Is it me? My services, my options. My services. Nope. Oh, there we go. Automatically post to Twitter when you start streaming on Twitch. Oop. There we go. Alright. So I'm going to look for Alien Breed. Special edition 902 Amiga level. Now GameSpot's pretty good with this sort of stuff, but Lemon Amiga has like all the stuff that I remember, all the original stuff. Oh man, look at that hidden messages of all the people that they've still got. Debbie Bestwick, right, she still works there. She's like the, I think she's the CEO, actually. If I remember correctly, I think she's the CEO of Team 17. But that's so cool to still see, like, some familiar names in there from, like, from way back. This is 1992, so, you know. It's a while ago. That's really cool. Okay, I've got some passwords here. So we've got 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 10. I'm going to put 5 in and see how we go. So that's UYTTA. There we go. That's what I was waiting for. So yeah, those passwords on GameSpot aren't right. Some of them are, but some of the passwords aren't. And that's why I like Lemon Amiga, because we're typically pretty good at that. All right, let's see where we end up. Level 5 is going to be maybe not quite where we want to be. So Power Mech Systems. Deck A, the deck lift to lower levels has been damaged and travel will have to... Oh, I don't remember this at all. We must have skipped this. I'll have to be restricted to the maze-like confines of the engineering ducts. Find duct 3 and quickly make your way down to the central core. Remote location scanner highly recommended. I have a feeling that this is the one that I was mentioning about, that being really dark. I think this is the really dark one. Darker than... Hard to see, not darker than. Yeah. Oh no. No, it's not. We're looking for deck. Looking for deck 3. Maybe. Oh, I don't know. I don't know which level we were on now. It might have been the one previous to this. Who knows? Oh, look. We've got slightly different aliens. And we've got some, like, let's call them silverfish sort of looking things there. Wow. Do we still have cheats? I just believe we still have cheats. Yeah, we do. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Hey, Dr. Disastrous, man. How's it going? Good to see you. Yeah, no, I've been up in OK, dude. How you been? Been a hot minute since we last saw you, dude. You doing all right, yeah? Good stuff. Good stuff, man. Glad to see you doing all right. What you been up to? Like, how's things going in your neck of the woods? Given we're surviving after walking through all this, I think still got the infinite ammo and infinite energy, so that's pretty good. It's going okay, nothing new. Okay. Oh, okay. Well, that's, I suppose that's good in some ways. Like, you know, no new disasters. Same for me, really, as well, you know. Still hacking away at Warframe, still playing Warframe. Playing something a little bit different for a change, really. Had a bit of a feeling, oh Jesus, knocking on all those doors, Christ. Just kind of wanted to play, something a little bit retro from my childhood. You've got a game you and me should play on stream? Yeah, sure, what's the game? What's your fancy? These little things. Oh, Rainbow Six. Okay, I gotta ask you, because I'm not against streaming Rainbow Six, don't get me wrong, because that seems pretty cool. Is it free, or is there like a free to play sort of start with version, or do you gotta play it? Do you gotta buy it? So I know Rainbow Six is like, they are killing it these days, you know, like they're still going strong. I do keep an eye out. I've fallen down here, this is not good. But I haven't actually played it myself, I'm gonna be honest. No, we're still stuck there. Look at it, there's little noises, like, oh, I can't get up there. It's sometimes free, but it's like $7 or $20. Okay, so so it tends to fluctuate a little bit. Okay, no worries. I'll keep my eyes open for it, dude. I will keep my eyes open. That's Duck 1. We need Duck 3. I imagine Duck 1 just kills you if you go in there. Oh, I guess we can't get in there because of this slight dome thing sticking out the wall. Seems a bit dumb. Oh yeah, I guess that's, a little bit of a bug or something. I don't know what's going on there. That's weird. It's better with two people. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I can imagine it's when you know who you're playing with. I see like other streamers playing it, like in squads and stuff, and then it always seems to be loads of fun, you know. So I think I'm actually trapped here, you know, because I'm not gonna die there, because, oh, there you go, I actually saw my energy go down there, so it did do something. Man, yeah, I think we're gonna have to try this again from the beginning, because I think I'm stuck here now. God, that sucks. Okay, all right. Right, let's just go here and we'll start from the beginning. I might just reload, actually. I'm gonna wait till it actually drains all my energy. Or, you know, maybe it doesn't, because of hacks. Alright, I'm gonna restart. And you can't load from disk 2, can you? No, okay. There, I'm gonna load from disk 1. We'll get right back into this. I think what I might do is I might go for the previous level as well. So that was level, I did level 5. Let's try level 4 and see how we go from there. That's really good stuff. That's really good stuff. Okay. We're loading up. I think we're still loading up. Gonna skip the advertisement this time. Probably should check out Alien Breed 2 at some point. Yeah, just gonna let this slide. We don't need to see this twice in one night. There we go. All right, let's give this another whack. I still want to play the other half of this. We had a good run there before it got a little bit. Well, before I died, basically. Maybe we should just enable debug mode and we'll go from there. Because that's got like a... that's got level skip and... Where's the debug mode? I want fish. Debug mode. F3 for more keys. F6 to destroy level. F7 to complete level. And F9 to walk through walls. We could go through the whole... Just go through the whole thing. Yeah, I still kind of want to give it a go without, you know, with the cheats, not completely breaking the game with debug mode. Maybe we'll try debug mode later on. Yeah, let's see. Let's see how we go. We good to go? Oh, there we go. Okay. So, can't go through the door. Get two keys. Get some creds. Okay, and cheat. Welcome to FinTech System. Okay, so key to the city. And this one, which I'm not going to say out loud. And there we go. Right, so that's the keys and the money. Sorry, keys and the energy. There we go, they're going up. So now let's do... I did level 5 before. Let's do level 4, which is L-A-E-E-A. There we go. Let's minimize my browser so I can see my chat. There we go. Alright, and then we'll see which level this is. Hopefully this is one that we, you know, left before. Yes, this is the one. This is the one. I thought so. No, I don't want to be beaten. I don't want to be beaten by the game. I really want to... I don't want to be beat by the game when I have cheats enabled. I'm not going to be beaten by the game when I have cheats. I shouldn't be beaten. I've cheated. I should win. Right, are we good to go? No, it's still loading. Alrighty. There we go. Alright. This is where we left off. Alright, previously on Dragon Ball Z. Alright. Oh god, now I'm saying it. But you watch like one or two people that reference something and then you start referencing it and it's like, I even watched Dragon Ball Z and like, the fuck is a Dragon Ball? Alright, So we've just got, we've got normal aliens, just normal aliens doing normal things. I feel like I've just been around in a big circle. I've done that twice now, so what the hell. let's go up this way. Alright, there's the fire door. I'm gonna get through that. I'm not gonna close it, because otherwise we'll just get dropped. I'm gonna save up that money again. Get the gun that we need. Get the gun that we desire. I feel like we're actually pretty close to the to where we needed to be, because last time I went like halfway around the map before we found out that we basically had to go the other way. Yeah, let's get those credits. We got some good credits. Okay, now I'm doing the whole circle thing again. Did we go through that before or not? I feel like we did. I really don't like those laser walls. Like, I feel like they're they do. They lower your health. It goes up afterwards, but it means you can't like stay there. It means you gotta get through them quite quickly. Things. Like, before we leave this level, I kind of want to get to one of the computers, and hopefully we've got the money to buy one of those guns. Here we go. This is where we were supposed to be. Ah, man. See, they put all those credits out as well. Like, hey, you want these, don't you? and then they go and screw you over with that red herring. I just love all the sound effects that they have for the different pickups and stuff. Like the ammo sounds like it's like a, I suppose it's supposed to sound like a gun reloading, but I always kind of felt like it sounds like a something getting snapped in half. Like a piece of wood or something. Oh no, we're not gonna go that way. I don't know, maybe we should just move on to the next level and we'll do the computer stuff there. try and do that. Because otherwise we might just end up dying in this level, and then this will all have been for nothing. So that's where we got to be. There's that. You can get trapped there really easily. So, and ready, and one. God, you've really got to get around that really quickly. Christ. Jesus. Alright, deck 7. Another large presence so it shows on scanning equipment. It might be the Queen Alien. If it is, then proceed with caution. Isolate and terminate anything you see moving. Survivors this deep into the station are unlikely. So we went to this level earlier on. Oh, there's no password for this level. Right. Now, of course, so there's only passwords for every few levels or so, and then there's ones in between, which is probably why I felt like things progressed like on a lot when we used like one of those passwords before, and this one not so much. Okay. So I'm just gonna walk into you. I'm not gonna reference you. Okay, so if the Queen Alien is here, then we have pyramids. I think we're definitely going to need that gun, otherwise this ain't going to be good. Even if we do have unlimited energy and all the rest. There's got to be a computer around here somewhere. Bear with me one second, guys. Okay, cool. Ah, oh, there's a computer, thank God. Alright, so that, ooh, is that that is a fire door sort of looking thing there. Okay. Oh, that looks like it is a big room for a boss, potentially. Right, how are we looking money-wise? Oh, that's fine. We got tons. So, radar. Yep, that looks like a boss fight area. We get to go all the way around there. We've got that duct there and that duct there. Okay. We've got money for that. Maybe I should get that. Oh, energy injection. Additional knife. So, is it M? It is M. Look at that. Alright, now we got a map. Probably should have done that before, but hey, there we go. Alright. Good stuff. Oh god, yep, that's the gun. Alright, I still thought I I was expecting the machine gun. Alright. So we've been through here before. I think we need to go that way. I think I'd read the map wrong there, because that looked open to me, but it's not. Let's go this way. Tell you what, Alien Brood could really do with a a comeback, like a real sort of comeback, not a like a survival horror alien isolation type comeback. Like Team 17 could do it, they could publish it. I don't know if they make games anymore or whether they're just publishing. I think they're indie publishers. I think they just do indie publishing now. I could be wrong. They might still make their own games. I think they might still make Worms. But I'm not sure. I don't want to speak out of turn because I like Team 17. So I don't want to assume anything because I don't know. I probably should just go look it up. But I would really like to see a return of Alien Breed, but in a more survival horror kind of sci-fi Alien Breed, Alien Isolation type game. Dead Space type game. Both of those really excellent games, which everyone likes. They could do it. They'd probably just make it first person or something. You could still make it first person. You could have aliens that sort of kind of resemble the xenomorph if you want, I guess. I mean, you don't have to. Could just be an off-brand Alien Isolation with nothing to do with Alien or Ripley in it or anything like that. Okay. Radar, I know we've got a map, but just to double check. That's there. Those doors there. We could go that way. We could go that way. We need to get there. Yeah, this is definitely a big bad, I don't say end level, but a big level, a main level, a bookend. Oh look, we got the tadpoles back. See, what I like about this, well, one of the things I like about this, one of the many things that I like about this, is like the levels change up. It's like there's a lot of Amiga games, and I like the Amiga. Like there's a lot of nostalgia there and all that for me. But like criticism where it's due and all that, like. More than a few of the games on the Amiga were better on other systems. Like a lot of the good games on the Amiga were better on other systems. Like ran better on other systems. And there are definitely a few sort of Amiga exclusive games which, you know, ran very well on the Amiga and were very good games in their own right and all that. But probably got ported to other systems as well, where you didn't have to worry about the loading or, you know, whatever, that kind of thing. Because they were on cartridge or whatever. We could install them on your PC and then they ran off the hard disk or, you know, whatever. They just could take advantage of the pluses of those systems. But I'll still be someone who sort of says, no, I prefer the Amiga version because it was written on the Amiga or for the Amiga initially, like Flashback and things like that. You know, excellent game. Love any version of Flashback, to be honest with you, because they're all good versions. There's not really a bad version of Flashback. But that said, you know, do I want to touch that? I don't, do I? Not after what just happened. I asked, you can't trust my smiley faces, man. Getting a bit lost here. One sec. Checking out those other Amiga games. As I say, criticism where it's due. There's a lot of Amiga games where they weren't great games. They kind of did the same thing over and over again. They didn't really progress. You know, maybe they were good for the first 5 minutes or so, or they had a good level in them or something like that, but. Like, in general, over time, they weren't a good, complete game, you know. There's, like, little things about them to like. And then you play the rest of them and it's like, oh, it's just this. There's nothing more here, you know. This, on the other hand, and flashback as well, just to throw that in there. And a few of the games, like they felt like proper, really complete games, which the level, the challenge progresses, the levels progress and move on, and aren't just copy pastes of each thing, and you're not just doing the same thing each time. It's really good stuff. This is definitely one of those games. And it's cool. It's the same thing, of course, but each level so far has been different. They've kind of each got their own little weird gimmicks and things, to be honest. Welcome to Intec Systems. I don't know where I'm going here. I've got a map already. And it's kind of nice to have a break. Have an Intex break. but yeah, it's like these games, a few of these games, especially this one, and a few others like it, they just feel really, really good. Like they progress, they change, they evolve as you play them, they've each got their own little, as I say, little gimmicks and things for each of the levels. Not just the same enemies over and over again. Granted, these are all very similar, but not exactly the same. There's at least some variation thrown in there. Whereas some Amiga games are just kind of very, straightforward. God, this is just the worst level in terms of navigating. This is the one I definitely don't remember as well. I'm going to be honest with you. When I used to play this as a kid, I remembered this so much better. I could have properly almost speed run this in a way. Swear to God, could have done. And I just don't remember it anymore. Which, I suppose the last time I actually played this properly all the way through, I would have been maybe my early 20s. Maybe. I got a thing there, but I feel like we're missing something. Like a boss. Yeah, definitely. I still got to take out that boss. These little, I don't like these little things. It's nothing to do with the sound, it's to do with how they look. Anyway. I would imagine they're like baby versions of the big ones. Am I trapped here again? Seriously? Are we doing this again? They really did like to do this, didn't they? You get trapped in levels. I think we are, I think we're trapped. I knew there was a reason I was supposed to be anxious about some of these levels. it's fine if you're already ready to go, but we're not. Oh my god. Okay, we probably just gotta restart, and we'll circle back around to this level. We should get actually pretty good at this, considering. Alright, so if we load this up, and then what I will do is get our levels ready to go. So we've got level 4. See, it says level 5, but that wasn't level 5, that was level 4.1 or something. I guess I'm thinking of levels as is it levels of the space station? Is it levels of the game? In which case, it's probably levels of the game, and level 5 is the next area, and we really are 4.1, 4.5 sort of thing in the middle after doing that one. But anyway, that's where we are. LAEEA, along with the rest of the cheats. So that's where we're at. So that's good. All right, we're just gonna go through all this. Let's load up and go through. I just got a tweet from one of my friends that I follow. Just talking about LaCroix. Yeah, apparently he's not a big fan of it. I don't really know what LaCroix is, at least I didn't before. It didn't really have any relevance to me, you know, before the Warframe stuff, for Reb and all of the cans of LaCroix. There we go, insert disc 2. Right, should be ready to go in a minute. There we go. I always liked this title music, like Alistair Brimble. I don't know if he still does work with him, but really, really good. Really good musician. Not gonna lie, haven't necessarily heard anything from him recently. Well, I'm sure he's doing good work still. Fingers crossed at least, you know. okay. See, it's just a jam, man. This is alright. There's been so many like reimagined versions of this, you know. It's pretty good. Anyway, let's get in. I'll keep on talking about how I'm not remembering so much of this game. I think I'm going to remember after this. I'm going to be seeing it in my sleep. I think about this, like, these days when you get stuck in a game where it's just like, you just like Alt F4 it, and you turn off your console, turn it back on again, you got an autosave, you go right back in, pretty much from where you left off, no big deal, you know? Really bringing it home right now, it's like, man, I didn't do that back then, did we? This is when we just restarted games because, and didn't, like, retry them again for for a while, for a day or two, you know, because it's just like, no, I'm not playing all that just to get that far before you knew about like cheats and stuff. Alright, here we go again. You know the drill, I know the drill. I just want to see the levels in between, man, that I really don't remember. I remember the first ones, and I remember more or less some of the last ones. So let's get my cheats. So okay, cool stuff. And last but not least, L A E A. Cool. I think we're still loading. I can just about hear it. It's quieter for me than maybe it is for you. But I turned it down a bit, so. So it wasn't so noisy. Okay, we're good to go? Good to go. Alright. Alright, guys. Here we go once again. It's safe to say that if I wasn't streaming this, I probably would have given up by now. And because I am streaming this, just give you that sort of that oomph to just say, no, I've got to get this finished and on record, you know. Right, now I'm playing with the idea of basically farting around with things and seeing what happens when I hit that smiley face as soon as we can get back right here. Like, it's the, I'm dying to know what happens. Like, does it still try and blow up the thing, or I've got to know. 1 second. We're just gonna wait that right here. Alien Breed Special Edition 992. Smiley face. I need to know what it does. Smiley face Amiga. What the hell do those things do? What are they supposed to do? And of course, because of what it is, like, you search that and Google's just like, I have no idea what you're talking about. I mean, I know what the Amiga is, I know what Alien Breed Special Edition 992 is, but I don't know how to put these two things together with the word smiley face and know what this does. Let's take Amiga off and see if that helps at all. Like, what is those smiley faces? I need to know. Maybe if I just search pickups, we can get like a list of pickups. I know you can't see any of this on stream, so I apologize. But just bear with me 1 second. I just want to see what this does. And, you know, I know, we could totally do it just in the game. And I probably will. If we can't find the reason for that here. Retro Gamer. Let's see what Retro Gamer says. Please, something, anything. Yeah, it's a review. Which is really interesting to see, like, a review of this old game. So, it would appear that, yeah, Alien Breed is on the Weyland Yutani Wikipedia, which I suppose makes sense because it's like highly derivative. Yeah, derivative, I suppose, is the word of Alien. So I've got some weapons. Okay, that's far enough. This is also Alien Breed, not Special Edition, but, you know, fair enough. I think they were similar to each other. Just not sure how similar. Yeah, no, I don't know. It's not on there, which kind of sucks. Okay. Alright, we are back to the machine gun though, which means we can fire with a little bit more reckless abandon and not worry about locking off fire doors, which is always good. Man. Oh, there's so many aliens here. This is close to the exit? Or am I going around in circles again? Let's find out. We do need these credits. So let's have those credits. I love the way it slows down like that. And it's just, I don't know why, but I really like that slowdown. Like, it's not the sort of slowdown that you get like in fighting games when they sort of, you know, you're doing so much damage that the computer can't take it, you know, that sort of thing, where it kind of feels like, man, this is so badass, the frames are dropping, you know, and the computer's slowing down. But it's obviously not that, because the game still runs fine. It's just slowing down that you've picked up all that stuff, and it's like it's processing that you've, like, in the background, like, the game's still running fine on top, but in the background it's just like, okay, you picked up that, and you picked up that, and then you picked up that. Like, it's very slowly just riding it all down. It's like, okay. Alright, let's go through the laser. You don't want to get trapped in there, because they will kill you, and that thing will kill you. There must be a way out. There must be a way out. I found it the other two times. We don't have the map, do we? No, we don't have the map. Well, I know we gotta go through here. Let's go through here. Let's go this way. Oh my god, why didn't I just do that? Right, credits, and credits. Don't forget those ones in the corner. There we go. You can see, like, the screen buffer. When the enemies are loaded in the corner, I think they're a little bit like, they're like the yellow, like they've just been damaged when they load in. It's really weird. I mean, it might just be a graphical glitch. It might even be an emulation thing. It might be nothing to do with the actual game itself, but just, I know, it's cool to see. I like seeing all those little things, and I just wonder, like, what's going on there, you know? What's going on there in the under the hood. And because, like, there's all these YouTube shows, you know, like, a lot of really good YouTubers out there, and well, contemporaries, all types. People who make videos and stuff. Like, they'll do those kind of deep dives on, like, the NES and or Nintendo stuff, because it's, you know, it's Nintendo stuff, and all that sort of thing. You very, very rarely ever get that kind of level of stuff with the Amiga, although it is getting there, because I guess people like me and, you know, all the people who used, like, the Sinclair and the Commodore 64 and the Amiga and all the rest of the thing, all those types of things, we're all getting to the age now where we're starting to make these these kind of in-depth videos and stuff. Now I'm starting to see a lot more of them now, rather than all the people who sort of grew up, which of course substantially more people who grew up with, like, Sega stuff and Nintendo stuff and all that, because they were more popular systems in general, you know, like the Amiga and all that sort of thing were generally more popular in the UK and Europe, and not so much in other countries, you know. Man, I felt like I was on a way to a winner there, and now I'm questioning my sanity. Oh man, I am so close as well. It's like, it's not that way. I know it's not that way. Because of that. Pretty sure we already came this way, but... Go down here. No, that's completely locked off, so it's not that way. Down. Let's go across. Did I just need to go down more? Was that it, really? Let's see what's this way. The funny thing is that I feel like I was probably better at this when I was younger, and that these days when I'm playing, like, when I'm playing a 3D game, and they give you, like, a choice of multiple sort of hallways to go down to find stuff, and you know, there's always almost, like, you know, you got something telling you where to go, so you go the opposite direction, so you find all the hidden stuff that they don't want you to find, because developers, they're sort of sneaky like that, and you're like, well, I'm not going to go the way that you tell me, because I want to find all the secrets that you don't want me to find. Or the extra ammo or health or whatever it is, you know. And that sort of thing. So close to turning on debug mode. I feel like I'm more used to doing sort of that kind of thing now, with like 3D space, and now that he's a 2D, like, I'm just not thinking, oh, I need to go check down that hallway, because it's not a hallway right now, you know, it's a top down two dimensional thing. I'm gonna just, like, go in a completely different direction for a bit. See if I can find, like, another way around, and it sort of helps me maybe reset my brain. Because I am just getting sort of almost blind to, like, seeing the same sort of patterns over and over again. Well, at least pick up that stuff. Come on. And get trapped in the door. Credits always good, like credits. Just because we got keys to waste, I'm gonna waste them. I'm just gonna pick up those keys anyway, why not? Such a satisfying sound when you pick them up. That's all I can say. Pretty good pickup sound. I like the door noises as well. Alright, I want to see what happens when you pick this up. Okay, right, they're normally one-ups. So that other one must be like a trick one. And all the rest of them, like, I guess, normal. Like, I knew what there was something about, like, the smiley face. I'm like, okay, that, like, puts sort of a fear of dread in me, and I know there's something wrong with that, but I don't know what it is. That's what it is. It's just that one. Or maybe there's more than one, but, you know, some of them are tricksters, and some of them are just normal one-ups, and that's what it is. That must be what it is. Alright, computer here, we're going to pick up some stuff. Right, we can't do anything around here, this is all locked off. So we found apparently the one computer in this level. We're going to use it. Welcome to Intech Systems. Oh yeah, plenty of money. I'll get the tool, we'll get the remote location. There we go. All right. I see where we are. I see where we were as well. We're pretty close. So I'm actually pointing at the screen, so you'll have to bear with me here. We are there. We're going to want to go through those there, and then we can either go around that way or we can go through that way. But we can get here. Where am I right now? I'm right there. That's where we started. Okay. Okie doke. So, for the benefit of us at home, where is capture cursor? I'm going to turn capture cursor on. Excellent. All right. That's where we got to be. That's the lift. That's the spicy one-up. We're going to go through there. We've got these doors to go through, or I guess we can go around that way. None of this way it works, so we're going to go through here. We're going to go through here, and here. And then we're going to go here. And if we're there, and I just need to get into this kind of area here. So that's what we're going to do. I've been playing this level for like 20 minutes. Feels like longer. Alright, so we're going to try and get out of this whole sort of section to like the beginning sort of section of the game. For some reason, I don't think that that's where we came from, but maybe we did. My memory is kind of mush at the moment with this level. Also because the other levels are kind of familiar looking and similar. So they do kind of mush together a little bit. But there's no other way to get out of this, no? Absolutely no other way. Okay. So we're here. That's where I thought. Yeah. So we're gonna go up here, around here, and then this way. No, not that way. This way, and up here, and around here, and then we're trapped here again. So no, we're gonna go backwards, and then we're gonna go down here, down through all here. I see, and through here. That's where the doors are. That two were open, two were closed, one was open. We opened all of them just to sort of take the piss for it. Go through here. And now we're trapped here again. God damn it. So here. No. This is absolutely absolutely infuriating. Right, go down here. Through there. Over here. Through here. Over this way. Oh, because that just gets us through that. How about that? This way. Oh no, that works. That works. Yeah, and all these rooms here, I remember those rooms, so we went here. We got sort of trapped around this sort of area, but if we go through there, and then through there, through here, and then through here, and down here, and then through all these, and then down, and then around, and then down, and that's where we got stuck. So what we needed to do was go up and over and through there, and then we went through here, and we got sort of trapped here. And we just needed to go over there, and then down here. And that would have been it. That would have been it. We would have got that. That's going to get really annoying if I leave that there, isn't it? There we go. Right. So, this has been a 2.5 hour stream of Alien Brute. I don't think the game's even 2.5 hours long. Although, you know, if we didn't cheat, it probably would be 2.5 hours, actually. But that's fine. It's fine. We do what we can. Yeah, have a bit of water. Pretty sure this is the wrong way to go. Yep. Need to go this way. Oh man, I was literally just looking at this on the map, and this is not the right way to go. See, the map makes you feel like that this is all like really big and huge, and like you could easily get lost in it. And it actually doesn't feel all that big. I'm not gonna lie. So let's try going up. Now I think we're going the right way. Nope. God, you were so close. All right, all I need to do is I need to go down that way and then through here and then through there. All right. There we go. That'll be it. That'll be it. Yeesh. Excuse me whilst I use my mind's eye, but believe we've got it. I think this is the right row. Bit further to go this way. I think we might be... close to the end here? Of this level? I think I might have gone the wrong way there. Yeah. I think it's this way, and then... yeah, I think this is it. Oh, we're gonna go get those credits. We can't leave those credits behind. Think of the credits. Hey, there we are. How long did that take? Seriously. Okay. Warning. Destruction. Jesus, every time. Okay, yeah, we're about ready to rock then. And make a bit of a start. I have to get through this next level. I'd love to remember how many levels there are in this game now. Alright, just bear with me one second here, guys. Right, sorry about that, guys. I'm back. Right, we're good to go. We still got that. Okay, that's good stuff. Now to remember how the hell to get to where we gotta be. So that's where we are. That's where the lift is. Yeah, the scales are a little bit off with that, eh? Now I'm just flipping back and forth between the two. You can definitely see how the scales are a little bit off between the two. It makes it look bigger than what it actually is. Which actually means that this is not such a huge map. And it kind of goes for the rest of them as well. So we didn't go this way last time we were doing this this level. So I'm feeling a little bit better about where this might take us. What I do know is I gotta stay out of those little sort of lowered areas so we don't get trapped in there again, because that'd be bad. That'd be very bad. Just wondering how much money we got actually. Oh yeah, now we got absolutely plenty. Okay, is this the... Yeah, that's where I thought we were. Okay, that's fine. So I don't want to spend too much time up there, because we went up there plenty the last time, and I feel like that's where I got lost. Whether or not that's really the truth, that's what I feel like. Okay. Alright, where are we going now? Oh god. Oh fuck me. Fuck me. Fuck me. God damn. Jesus Christ. I thought I might do that. That's why this gun's such a goddamn death trap. Alright, well, I'ma do a debug mode. Let's go do a debug mode. It's stretched my patience enough. I think I wanna try debug now. Because if we can just walk through the walls as well, then we can try that. Also, this will be fun. It's not like I'm in a rush or anything to finish it. I just want to try this. I just want to try this out. Right. Okay, bear with me, guys. Where is that sheet? Oh, wow. Where is it? Where is it? There it is. Right, I shouldn't know that. I want fish. Let's see if this works. Right, F9. Oh my god. We've got no clip. We've got no clip, my dudes. Oh yeah, now we can walk through everything. Oh, this is amazing. I was not expecting the alien queen to be there. Scared the shit out of me. God damn it, alien queen. Also, that's not like the alien queen. I know there's another alien queen that looks more like the alien queen. So we go usually like this way in there. So we've got a one-way laser saw field in here. Come on, man, leave me alone. I keep pressing fire. I'm trying to walk away. I'm trying to do all the things I think we're supposed to do. Okay, we've got 100 seconds to get out of here, so I'm gonna roughly go where we would go, you know, to try and keep the tension up a little bit. So we would normally go down here and then down here. Yes, that's not the way that we would usually go. So they let you out that way. You go up here, then up there. They give you plenty of time. So I guess you can get down that way. Oh, we can't go. Look at that. It's, oh man, you know what? It's gotta be around here somewhere. Oh, that's it. That's it. We had to go that way. We had to go all the way around here. There we go. Alright, I'm very happy with that. I'm very proud of myself. Thank you very much. You're welcome. You're welcome, game. You're welcome. My Biomech systems. This is where we were before. Deck lift to the low levels, been damaged, travel will be restricted, the maze, confines, engineering docks, find the dock 3, da 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 da, remote location scanner, I highly recommend it. Still loading, so we're just gonna hang fire for a sec, until it's done loading. I'm just checking my messages and we're good to go. Got stuff to do. Okay, right. We can still walk through walls. That's good. It's going to completely trivialize the rest of the game, I know, but I'm still going to give it a go. See, the worst thing about this like stuff sometimes, and it was the same with Doom, and it's like no clip and all that as well. So the thing is that because you can go anywhere, like levels are designed to kind of, you know, they're designed to like have a flow to them and to direct you in the way that you should go through them. So it's a little bit tough. Just wondering, like, I've got no keys left. But look, it's just If you look at the bar at the top, like, it's taking my ammo away now. But it just doesn't really seem to matter. I've got unlimited keys anyway, but... and then the text is sort of disappearing. Oh, let's go take all that stuff down. That looks great. Alright, bear with me, guys. Jesus, that you must really, really want to get that computer area there. But yeah, sorry, I am just wandering around this level with not a care in the world. But yeah, like, if you try to actually play the game and use it all the time, then you'd just sort of get lost because you could go anywhere and you had no sort of direction to go in. Or at least I did, anyway. I felt like that. It's like, well, the game's sort of made to give you a direction to go in. Oh god, I'm in the void. I don't want that. I hear it makes you go a bit weird. Or weirder in my case, I guess. Alright, I wonder over that. I wonder if you can just... Okay, now you do stick, you still do stay within the play area there, so that's good. That's interesting. At least your bullets do as well, they stay within the area. So duct one, that's not a place we want to be. We want to be duct three. And oh my god, this is a huge level. Oh yeah, we're gonna take a walk the other way for sure. It really is a maze, isn't it? They did say it was gonna be just a maze going through all these ducks. Actually really pleased that we tried the debug mode now. Cause just wanting to get the most amount of cash anyway in these levels. Oh, that's cool. Look at that. It's like I said, man, like they keep on finding new, different things to do with each level. And not just like relying on the same old tricks. She got like new things each time. I like that. It's such a small sort of budget game for a system which, not, you know, wasn't the biggest setting system or anything like that. I mean, Amiga was popular over here at least, and I believe in Europe as well. You know, over here in Europe. But it still wasn't like huge. And the video game industry wasn't huge back then, you know. Anyway, sorry, and let's stop jerking around here and we'll get to that's Doctor 4, so we want 3. I found 1 and 2. God, so many critters. Someone just threw balance out the window entirely with this one, didn't they? Alright, so now we're in the corner, so it must be up the other way then. Where I'm just like touching doors, but going through the rest of the wall. There it is, duct 3. You notice how they all have danger on and this one doesn't have danger on? It's interesting. Alright, there we go. So what's this one? Is this the dark one? Engineering system shaft, which links deck 8 and reactor core. Reactor core sounds interesting. And then pawn. Quickly locate and use grill. Lift, the grill lift. Okay. That will take you to the central reactor core. Security sensors have been triggered and you are advised to move quickly. Fortunately, there seems to be no movement in the shaft complex. Not that that makes the task any easier though. Right. Okay, yeah, no, this is not the one I was thinking of, but that's fine. Holy shit. Yeah, no, I remember looking for these. Yep, I remember that being a thing as well. Holy crap.
Warning. Destruction imminent.
So I believe that triggers just after so long of you being in here because, you know, you're not supposed to be here. God, I think it's in one of these corners somewhere. I seem that to remember that being the thing, but of course not sure, not 100%.
Warning. Destruction imminent. Warning. Destruction imminent.
That's where we started. God, I thought that was it then.
Destruction imminent.
Okay, not long to go, not long to go. Where are we? Where are we?
Destruction imminent.
God damn it. Okay, but with debug mode, we can why is it flickering on 4? Anyway, doesn't matter. We can get through this quickly. So we can just go from level 1 and then just complete with the key press. Oh, debug mode is still on. Excellent. We don't have to do anything. Alright then. To complete level F7. Alright, this is going to probably get a little bit funky. But we'll go through each level till we get to where we were. Where we are, we're gonna go again, level 3. This one's the one which is the security zone. So we blew up the pub. We blew up the power subsystem. I know what's in the pub. That's meltdown spreading this level, not stopped. This is the fire door one. So let's move on with this. Come on. There we go. Right. Fire doors. Oh, really? Okay, well, it's the fire door one. Let's move on. Deck 4. Alright, oval zone. I remember this one. There we are. So we would get the next what's that? Get the next oh man. Lift. Get the next lift. So we're in the oval zone. That's this one, and then seven once again. Move on. Take five. Evil smell fills the air. Yep. Evil smell. Know what evil smells like? Know what evil tastes like? Okay, we're good to go. All right. So this would be the boss. Then we go next again. Then the boss, engineering subsystem, deck 6. Which you use lane, one of many. We're gonna go deck 7, the engineering main deck. L-A-E-E-A, this is where we were before. Moving on, engineering, deck 7. Another large presence. This might be the alien queen, it isn't. If it is, then proceed with caution, isolate and terminate anything you see. Moving survivors this deep in the station are unlikely. I like how at this point it's like, yeah, there ain't gonna be no survivors. Before it was like, hey, there might be some survivors, but this one's like, nah. Alright, there we go, complete. Power mech systems, deck 8. Yep, where was that? U, or maybe V. Let's say U. U-Y-T-T-A. This is the docked one, yeah, docked 3. God, you could be stuck on this level for ages. There's so much going on in this level. It's a good thing there's a password for it, to be honest. Alright, now we're in the docks where we were before, and the thing is, security goes in, the security system is going to be triggered. And then it's gonna start counting down. I've definitely done this, granted with cheats, but like not through just walking through the walls. I used to know the way through those vents, but I guess I don't anymore. Like even with like unlimited keys and stuff, like this is still a really fun game to sort of go through and try and figure out, you know. All right. We did it. Let's see where we are now. So this is reactor core. This is deck 10. This is PPEAB. So this is the final, I think, the final, if not one of the final levels. Priorities to the reactor, find the central core. Reactor in zone 6. This will prepare the whole station for meltdown and provide an escape in the shuttle. Adjust victory against the renegade alien force. Make for the shuttlecraft lift when the core meltdown is initiated. So I believe this is where we do that, and then we have the alien queen boss, I think. And then maybe it's I think there's the darkness one after this, because we get like a little bit trapped in it before it goes off. But maybe not. Let's find out. Ah, okay. So, what I do remember from this is the clean level. There's another level which is very alienified. Also, this is like got all desks and stuff in it, so I remember this being like the administration sort of area. So I kind of want to find a computer, so we can at least pick up the maps. Find it, of course. There might not be one in here, but I just don't remember. I remember this being possibly a good way to go. I'm just gonna get all the doors. Okay, so obviously this is the end of the thing. Right, now this is starting to make a bit more sense. Oh my god! How dare! Fair enough. I'm gonna get that thing. And I'm actually gonna buy one of the other weapons and we'll try that out just for shits and giggles, really. What do we got? We got 4,000. Well, that's 10,000. That's 24,000. That took me way too long to read that number. Alright, well, we got that. We got that thing. Cool. Although I'm gonna go all the way through this like that, so you come through here, you go through there, you had to destroy those things and you touched that, and then you had to go through there. Fire door there, we had to go through there. There's one way thing there. I can't remember if it's the lift where we started. Oh, there's another one and I'm forgetting it. Ah, there it is. Of course, we've always got S7 if we need that, so. Anyway, we'll continue. Location unknown, that's it. Yeah, it's location unknown. Well, no wonder the level didn't have, like, a name or anything. That's why. Lift malfunctions left you in near darkness. Blue eyes are coming at you from all directions, and your only hope is to move quickly and trust your laser. Escape from this living hell is the only option. It looks like this was some sort of security zone, so caution is advised. Long story short, don't touch the walls. Yes, this is it. This is what I remember, and it's a very wide open sort of a level as well. But I like how all the lighting is, and it just looks really good. I am hovering over the S7 key just in case, but I seem to remember there being a lift somewhere over here. Gotta be careful. Gotta be careful. Can't touch the walls. Don't want to touch the walls. Oh, I think this is a good sign. I think it was around here, maybe. There it is. Right, the hatchery. Here we go. This is where things start to get a bit alien fired. You're almost wretch as the foul stench hits the back of your throat. You realize exactly who is down here. These are there are eggs everywhere, and slime covers the biofilm walls. What does this sound like? It sounds like, well, aliens, and also kind of like the infested as well. Your mission is simple: kill the queen, get out before the station goes up. All right. So this is, yeah, there we go. Oh yeah, there's the eggs, and you walk over them and they open. Yeah, they really went all out with this one. I remember this. I mean, it's gross, but it's kind of great as well. They really nailed it. It's really not good that I don't like that. I don't like the noise. Can we get the map? Ah, it's weird. We haven't got the map anymore. Maybe it gets removed. I'm trying to remember how to get to the... Get to the queen now. It's definitely around here somewhere. Oh, here it is. Gosh, she does that way too much. I just have no idea, like, what to do here other than... And you obviously can't, like... get out of there completely, so I guess you must have like had to save up on like lives and all that kind of thing. So there we got 13 seconds to get out. Granted, the lift is right there, but still, you know, it's a bit spooky. And that's it, that's the game. Those last three levels you kind of got to do all together. You can't really get to that bit, you know. Of course, because this is a budget release, it's like, yep, here you go. There you go, you cheated to get all ripped your way through this fantastic end sequence. Then well done, haven't you really? And also completely wasted satisfaction and pleasure. Alien Breed 2, yeah. The old days of video game development, eh? Alright, well there we go. Now we'll do the name properly. Not that it'll really matter, but you know, for posterity. Posterity, rather, posterity. Right, it's fine, there we go. I'm not gonna go find what the backspace key is. All right, that's about 2:46 for me. So it's not too far 3 a.m. for me either. So I think we're gonna wrap up this stream, and I'll see you in the next one, guys. Might actually play a bit of Warframe in the next one, but I thought it'd be cool to play something a little bit different for a change. Definitely something that I I've been meaning to sort of come back to. To be fair, I also want to play the demo of Destroyer Humans as well, whilst that's available. Because I used to play Destroyer Humans on PS2, and I wouldn't mind seeing what the remake's like of that. But yeah, at some point as well, we'll get back into Warframe. Warframe's going to be there for a while, I think, for me, so nice to play something different for a change. So yeah, well, hope you had a good one, guys. Thanks very much for watching, as always, and I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy, guys.